July 2019, one of my very best friends, he and I were getting our PhD in the same lab. He came down to visit me here in New Orleans, and both of us went to historically Black colleges and universities. And so, you know, Black history is extremely important to just who we are as people. And we wanted to visit the Whitney Plantation, which is about 45 minutes away from New Orleans. And so we went down there, and I kind of strong-armed my older daughter to come down with us. And so she came down with us and was, you know, dragging her feet and not really that engaged. But then she walked into that exact same house that we took that photo in front of, and sort of had an aha moment. And she told me, you know, Dad, I finally understand what it means and how important it is to be an African-American doctor in America. And of course, I was shocked because we're talking about an eight-year-old with such an important realization, although I had reiterated that exact point to her very many times in the past. It was great to hear from her that she had understood it. And I asked her, well, why'd you, you know, come to that conclusion? And she said, well, just think about it. You know, we just came from a place where historically people like us were enslaved when we weren't even allowed to read or write or do mathematics or to think about science. And just to think about how far we've come to where I'm riding in the car with two Black doctors is wild. Like, that's a long way to come. And so, of course, I looked over at Philip and said to him, like, man, I have this idea. I want to do something that's iconic, but I got to get some support. So I went and talked to Sydney Labat, Rachel Turner, some of those exact same people that are in the photo, and they all agreed that this would be something amazing. And I think we knew that those photos were iconic. What we didn't know was how impactful it would be. There's no way we could predict that. But what we did was a very smart, and I think our ancestors would be proud for the decision we made, was that we didn't just take the attention for clout. We utilized it to do something really amazing, which was to take that photo and put it in the classrooms all over the globe, from England to Tanzania to China, Korea, to all over Brazil, and even obviously all over here in our own country. And then we also decided, like, hey, let's figure out a way to decrease the financial burden to become just like us. And specifically, the financial hurdle it takes just to get into medical school. And just most recently, we've thought about ways to ensure that literacy, especially culturally relevant, age-appropriate literature, is accessible to students. And so one of the things that we've started to imagine is having a 15 White Coats book box in classrooms all over the country, with books that are age-appropriate for kids who are in K-5 or 6-9, and then, you know, 9-12. And then those kids can check in and out of those books, and we can start to think about, you know, what is the impact of kids having access to culturally appropriate literature, the Ta-Nehisi Coates, the Maya Angelou, the Dick Gregory books, the books that really speak to the experience of minoritized populations, not only in our country, but globally. So that's where we are now. And we're partnering with amazing companies like Children's Hospital New Orleans and many others to make sure that we can expand our reach and do even more impactful things in the future.